Hey, my name is Carter Smith, and I'm the writer and director of Jamie Marks is Dead. For me, it's just so exciting because I've never had a film in this festival before, and you know, there's so many other great films here. I'm psyched to get to see the films, and you know, just to be a part of it is amazing. So Jamie Marks is Dead is a ghost story. It's a story about a murdered high school boy who comes back as a ghost looking for the love and the friendship that he never had when he was alive. And I think that it's based on a book called One for Sorrow by Christopher Barzak. And when I read the book, I fell in love with the characters. And I fell in love with this kid, Jamie Marks, who, you know, just never had the friends, the companionship that is so important in your teenage years, and telling his story was really exciting to me. Adapting a book is tricky because, I mean, obviously I fell in love with the book in the first place, which made me want to make the film, and then, you know, being forced to get rid of stuff and cut stuff out is always really difficult. I mean, I think that the big thing is at a certain point I have to leave the book completely behind and only deal with the script, and that's when you realize if the script is working or not. You have to once you stop sort of comparing it to the book. I work pretty closely with the book in the beginning stages, and then I put it in a drawer, shut it, and don't look at it again until much, much later, like when I'm stuck or when I'm, when there's really a reason to pull it out. Casting was tricky because I was really committed to, these are kids, these are high school kids, and I really wanted high school age, I wanted teenagers to play these parts. And, once you start dealing with actors that are, really 16, 17, it makes it more difficult from a production standpoint because you can shoot less hours and you can, but it also is a much smaller group of actors you have to look in. But we managed to get all real teenagers to play the parts, and it wasn't quick, it wasn't easy, but I will say that each of them, when I read with them for the first time, it was very clear that they were the right actors. The thing that I think that makes this story universal is that it's about loneliness and it's about connection and it's about intimacy. And, you don't have to be, a bullied high school loner to have an experience with intimacy or with isolation. I mean, I think that all of us have things that we've sort of gone through in high school or any time in our life that make it easy to relate to someone who's in Jamie's shoes. And I think that's one of the things that makes it appeal to a wider audience. There's one scene in the film when the ghost of Jamie Marks shows up in Adam's bedroom, and it's this very awkward scene where it's like they're not really sure how they should be dealing with each other, and there's this great moment when Adam sort of decides he's okay with it, and so he sort of allows he gives Jamie a sweatshirt of his to wear, and there's something, I mean, it's such a small gesture, but I think that for me, was a moment in the story that said so much about Adam's character, and how Jamie reacted to it, said so much about him. And it was a very, very small scene, but for me, it was one of the first scenes we filmed, and once we'd filmed that, I was like, okay, I've got the best two actors for this, and this is going to go well. My hope is that an audience, first of all, and they enjoy the film, they get sucked into the story, and they enjoy the journey. But, I hope that it's also, it's optimistic, and it's sort of, they leave with a sense of hope and optimism about, that certainly life is not as difficult as it seems when you're a 16-year-old, you know, high school junior, you know, and I mean, those of us who, as adults, you know, we obviously know that, but, you know, I think that can be pretty difficult to see past that, you know, when you're living it, so...